हेलो गाइस, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट कॉइल ट्यूबिंग स्ट्रेट बार. हियर वी हैव, एज यू कैन सी विद मी, वी हैव अ कॉइल ट्यूबिंग स्ट्रेट बार विच इज बेसिकली 278 स्ट्रेट बार. ओके, दिस कॉइल ट्यूबिंग स्ट्रेट बार इज वन ऑफ द कॉइल ट्यूबिंग डाउनहोल टूल्स कंपोनेंट, दैट इट इज वन ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ द कॉइल ट्यूबिंग BHE. एज यू कैन सी, इट इज बेसिकली अ स्ट्रेट पाइप. As you can see, this straight bar is basically, as the name indicates, a straight piece of pipe. But the difference between this pipe and the coil tubing itself is that it is a heavy wall, that its wall thickness is much more than the coil tubing which we use to run the coil, this straight bar. So this straight bar have more wall thickness as compared to coil tubing. Talking about the size of straight bar, it is usually 3 feet to 6 feet. Sometimes it is 3 feet and also sometimes it is 6 feet. So depending upon the requirement, we can choose that which straight bar we have to use, either 3 feet or 6 feet or in between, like 4 feet or. So usually the size is from 3 feet till 6 feet. Talking about the configuration, it have two ends as all of the downhole tools. This one the pin end and this one the box end, as you can see. And on its both ends, either its box end or the pin end, it have a standardized thread. When I say standardized, it means the threads which are usually used for the coil tubing downhole tools. Talking particularly about this straight bar which I right now have with me, which is 278, its thread are 238 pack threads. Okay, 238 pack threads. Here also, these are the pack threads. Okay, talking about the application, that why do we use a straight bar in our BHA. So there are two reasons. The first reason is to extend the BHA length. Now the question arises that why do we need to extend the length of the BHA. The answer is the extended length help to pass the CT downhole tools through the restricted portion in the wellbore, that is some nipples or some crossovers, especially in horizontal or deviated sections. So when the coil tubing is being passed through a deviated section and there is some restricted component, that is some nipple or some crossover, then this straight bar, or you can say the prolonged or the extended length of the BHA, it helps to pass through that restriction. How it helps to pass? It is because of the increased stiff length. BHA is much more stiffer than the coil tubing. Coil tubing have the bending capability, the buckling capability, okay, but this BHA is a stiff part, or you can say that it is a rigid section. So when we add the this straight bar to the BHA, the length is increased, so we have more stiff part which is less prone to bending. So ultimately it helps to pass through the restrictions or limited entry points in the wellbore. Okay, the second reason of using straight bar in our BHA is that we use it in between hydraulic jar and accelerator. So why do we use in between hydraulic jar and accelerator? The reason is the weight of the straight bar helps to give more effect, more impact of the jar. So to increase the jarring impact, we use straight bar in between accelerator and hydraulic jar. So this is the second application of a straight bar. Talking about the precaution, that what precautions or what safety measures we have to take prior running this straight bar into the hole is that we should make sure that its ID, okay, its ID is enough that any ball we have to drop to activate the downhole tool below the bar could pass, or simply its ID should be enough that we can run the ball later if we need to continue our operation. So the ball required to activate the downhole tools should pass through this straight bar. So this precaution we should take prior running any straight bar. That was a small discussion about straight bar. I hope that you have got understanding regarding what we have discussed. So if you found value in the video, please like, subscribe and share with your colleagues. Thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.